estuaries as marine ecosystems. Aquatic ecosystems are of two types, as freshwater ecosystems and marine ecosystems. The habitats of the open sea and the coastal zones come under marine ecosystems. The open sea occupies about 90% of the total surface area of the oceans, but they contains only 10% of all marine plant and animal species. About 30% of the world's primary productivity comes from plants living in the ocean. Marine ecosystems also include the salt marshes and the wetlands located along the shores and the river mouths. Within the coastal zone, several unique habitats like estuaries, tidal inlets and foreshore ecosystems are also included. At the mouth of every old stream and river, there will be an aquatic condition which includes the habitat of both fresh and salt waters. These are called as estuarine environments. Estuaries are the coastal areas where the saline waters of the ocean meet with the fresh water of streams and rivers. Estuarine habitats are usually very productive because of the accumulation of nutrients from a large catchment of the river. Estuaries offer good fishing grounds as the water column is shallow and approachable. These zones are the breeding habitat for a variety of shrimp and prawn species, oysters and fish. They also provide sheltered harbors for ships and their traffic. Estuarine waters are used for cooling of water in power generation plants. In this episode, the following modules are covered: the definition and description of estuaries, the ecological factors of estuaries, the estuarine life, the productivity of estuaries, and the protection of estuaries. Let us see the definition and description of estuaries. The term estuary has been derived from the Latin word estus. It means heat or boiling. The term estuarium means tidal. This term is coined to denote a place where the impact of tides are more. An estuary is a semi-enclosed coastal body of water that has a free connection with the open sea at one side and a river on the other side. It is a typical ecosystem wherein the sea water of the sea and the fresh water derived from the land are mixing together. The circulation in any estuary depends on the amount of fresh water outflow and the strength of the tidal currents and the amount of vertical mixing. Estuarine waters are therefore salty or brackish in quality. Structurally, they are deep funnel-shaped mouths. They are complex ecosystems comprising of three important zones as polyhaline zone, mesohaline zone and oligohaline zone. The marine or lower estuary that has a free connection to the sea with salinities equal to that of the oceanic waters is called as the polyhaline zone. The total dissolved solids of the water of this zone may range from 30 to 35 parts per trillion. The middle estuary, which is subjected to strong salt and fresh water mixing, is called as the mesohaline zone. The salinities of this zone may be around 15 ppt in the waters. The upper or fluvial estuary, which is characterized by the flow of fresh water, is known as the oligohaline zone. The level of salinity in these zones may be around 0 to 5 ppt. Ecologically, an estuary is an area of dynamic biogeochemical activity. Estuaries are critical for the survival of many species of birds, mammals, fish and other wildlife. These brackish water ecosystems provide marine and other life with the habitat for shelter, food and production. Rivers and streams drain into estuaries, bringing in enormous nutrients from uplands. Plants use these nutrients along with the sun's radiant energy, carbon dioxide and water to manufacture the food. As long as the nutrient rich fresh water flows towards estuaries and there is tidal interaction, estuaries will remain productive. Estuaries may be small or large depending upon their size, shape and the quantity of river flow. All are controlled by the climatological and geomorphological conditions. The sediments carried by the streams are also dropped in the quiet waters of the estuaries. Such sedimentation may also shorten the dimension of estuaries, especially in the upper reaches. Estuaries are classified into four basic types as classical type, fjords type, bar-built estuaries, tectonically formed estuaries. Let us see the characteristics of these types of estuaries. The classical type estuaries are called Ria type estuaries. They are the drowned river valleys. These are coastal plain estuaries. Most familiar is the drowned river valley type estuary available in different parts of the world, where the rise of sea level and the lowering of the river mouth may be creating these types of classical estuaries. A fjord results from glacial scoring and is usually deep with steep sides. A sill or rock bar is situated at the mouth of the fjord. Having been deposited there, when the glacier receded, estuaries are formed. The bar-built estuaries are shallow-fed estuaries formed by more than one river. The tectonically formed estuaries are formed due to faulting or any other tectonic activity induced by the earth. And these tectonically formed estuaries are also existing in different parts of the world. Let us see some other parts of estuaries. A lagoon is a broad, shallow estuarine system capable of holding enormous water and marine life. The flow of water between the estuary and the coastal ocean is restricted by a barrier beach, generally paralleling the shoreline. Where tectonic processes are active, tectonic estuaries may be formed by faulting, landslide, or volcanic eruption. Let us see the ecological factors of estuaries. The ecological factors controlling the life of estuaries are the stream flow, salinity of water, tides, waves and currents, turbulence, silt and mud, temperature and sunlight. Let us see the characteristics of these factors. Stream flow is an important factor of estuaries. Estuarine conditions result from the interaction of a one-dimensional river flow with the oscillating ocean tides and wind. Season and rainfall determine the amount of stream flow coming towards an estuary. Salinity is an important factor in the aquatic environments. In an estuary, the fresh water of the river mixes with the salt water of the oceans or the seas. Salinity in estuaries varies with reference to space and time. It varies vertically and horizontally. The variation can also be seen within one tidal cycle in the estuaries. There may be a gradational change in the chemistry of estuarine water. Due to these variations, some chemical substances may be dissolved more, some of the dissolved solids may undergo precipitation, some others are either absorbed or adsorbed on the particles of silt, clay and organic matter. Concentration of a certain element may also vary depending upon the salinity variations, and the decomposition of organic detritus occurs due to the rapid flow of biochemical materials or biological materials, water and sediments. As water is lesser in density than seawater, it flows out on the top of dense saline water. Salinity variations will be less when currents are strong enough to mix water thoroughly. at low tide zones and times, at periods of tidal overmixing, and due to the absence of wind. The fresh water has a salinity of 0.065 ppt, and the fresh to brackish water has 0.3 ppt. Since the concentration of metallic salts carried by streams varies from basin to basin, the salinity and chemistry of estuarine waters differ considerably. The salinity depends on the seasonal and climatological factors. It is expected to be very high during summer and drought periods. It will be very low during winter and spring. Such changes have a profound impact on the life of the estuary. The wind controls the tides in some estuaries, and it causes complex surface currents in most estuaries. The wind is helpful for mixing of water. A tide is the periodic rise and fall of ocean and bodies of water connecting them. Tides are caused by the attraction of sun and moon. This is a physical environmental factor in estuaries. Tides are a function of the sun's and moon's gravitational pull on the oceans on the earth and the rotation of the earth. Tidal action causes salinity fluctuations. High tide and low tide each occur 2 times a day. When the river flow is normal, tidal cycles produce a normal or positive type of estuary. In this estuary, low salinity will be there towards the river side. When the river flow is poor, the tidal cycles produce a negative type of estuary. At the time, the high salinity will be there at all places. Current is an important factor in estuaries. A current is a stream of water which flows on the surface of a large water body. Estuaries are subjected to 2 types of currents, one produced by the river and the other generated by the sea. The oceanic currents are localized movements of masses of seawater due to tidal forces, density differences, and the wind action. The major types of currents which can be expected in estuaries are the following: tidal currents, salinity currents, temperature currents, turbidity currents, and the wind currents. In broad estuaries, the river current is slow. In narrow estuaries, it may be rapid. In estuaries with sandbars at the mouth, the tidal currents will be slowed down. Let us see the characteristic features of waves. Waves are formed when the particles of water move up and down at the same place. They denote the vertical movements in seawater. Waves may be of small destructive type or constructive type or a large plunging type. These may not affect the biota of estuaries. The force of incoming waters are nullified by the velocity of river flow at estuaries. Waves are always caused by winds. The impacts are very high in some parts of the estuaries. Waves impact the sessile animals and plants. If large, these waves can uproot the vegetation. They cause physical disturbance to the benthic animals caused by the tides as well. Tidal wave is the movement of a tidal flow in estuaries. The next factor of estuary is the turbulence. This is the flow of water in which the motion of individual particles, that is suspended particles, appears irregular and random. It is produced by the constant mixing of seawater and fresh water. It occurs vertically or horizontally. Turbulence is expected to be greater at the boundaries when the fresh water meets the seawater. Turbidity and light are very important factors in estuaries. The light levels determine the primary production. So turbidity also has a role to play in primary production. If the light is low in estuary, primary production drops. Light is inversely related to turbidity. Sediment causes high turbidity, and clear water will have no turbidity, but turbid water will have more sediments and high turbidity. Let us see the other factors like silt and mud. Due to the interaction of waves, tides, and currents with the stream flow, silt and mud will get settled down in estuaries. life at the bottom of estuaries are controlled by these materials. The temperature of water present in estuaries is a very important factor for life. This is highly dependent on the solar heat, temperature of the river water, the sea water and the season. Thermal gradients are expected in estuaries and are distributed over the depth of water column on all sides. The upper layer of estuarine water may be cooler in winter and warmer in summer than the bottom. The mixing of waters of different salinities and temperatures act as nutrient controllers in estuaries. The productivity of an estuary is controlled by all these factors. Estuaries have higher productivity always. This is due to the inflow of nutrients and oxygen brought by the tides. Enormous other nutrients are also supplied by the river water. Due to the turbulence and vertical mixing, nutrients are circulated throughout the estuaries and the productivity is maintained. The oxygen levels in the estuaries are very important. Dissolved oxygen provides the oxygen for respiration of life in estuaries. Dissolved oxygen is highest near the ocean in estuaries, and they are very important for all animal life. Chemical nutrients like nitrates and phosphates are available in estuaries, and they are very important for the survival of life. Let us see the third important module, the estuarine life. The survival of any organism in estuary depends on several factors like salinity, depth, temperature, turbulence, currents and the sudden occurrences of hurricanes and heavy rain. Almost all life face the problems in estuaries like the maintenance of their position and adjustment to the changing environmental conditions. Estuarine organisms are mostly benthic, mostly secured attached to the bottom mud or buried in the mud. Some of them occupy in the crevices of rocks and cracks. They are followed by some motile inhabitants and planktons. Many of the crustaceans and fishes come under these categories. The salinity dictates the distribution of life in any estuary. Some organisms, if marine, may be able to withstand the seawater. Some freshwater organisms may not be able to live under changing salinity. The population of any species or subspecies is determined by the salinity zonation of estuaries. Snook, trouts, mullets, jack and many other organisms, they survive in estuaries, and many of them are marine animals. Depending upon the healthy condition in the estuary, they survive. Estuaries also provide breeding and nesting habitat for many of the coastal birds, including several endangered species such as brown pelicans. The characteristic features of estuarine life are included under planktons, nectons and benthons. Planktons are at the mercy of waves and currents. They may be taken towards the sea by the ebb tides. If the water circulation is more and vigorous, planktonic population will be less. They require nitrates, phosphates and adequate sunlight and well aerated water. Cold currents are rich in nitrates and phosphates. Meeting of warm and cold currents aerates the estuarine water. Size influences the range of motile species in estuarine waters. Smaller and younger fishes may live in low salinity water. On growth, they may move down to more saline zones also. Estuary is also considered as a maritime nursery. It is a place where young fishes and a few other organisms are protected from predators and competitors which may not be able to enter into the low salinity waters. Due to salinity variations, marine species drop out towards the riverside and are not replaced much by freshwater forms. The number of species also decreases. Any sudden inflow of fresh water due to heavy rainfall or hurricane may sharply change the salinity conditions of estuaries. This will cause a high mortality rate of many of the life in estuaries. The larval forms may be affected more than the adult ones of many organisms. oyster is a dominant estuarine organism. It is attached to the hard objects at the intertidal zones. They construct reefs at right angles to the direction of currents. Barnacles and bryozoans attach to these oyster shells. They depend on oyster or algae for food. Bryozoans, oysters, worms, decapods and pelecypods live in all these estuaries. Diatoms, dinoflagellates are also dominant as phytoplanktons in estuaries. The zooplanktons may include many permanent and temporary organisms, and their entry and exit may depend on several factors controlling the estuaries. By way of burrowing, contraction, moving to a safe zone, moving into their own shells and acclimatation, estuarine organisms react to the salinity stress. Life forms in estuaries can be classified based on two factors as salinity and motility. Estuary contains many mobile or other forms which migrate from river to sea or the rivers. The forms migrating from river to sea are called catadromous, and the forms moving from sea towards the river are called as anadromous. Based on the tolerance of salinity, estuarine forms are also classified into oligohaline, urihaline and true estuarine forms. The oligohaline forms are belonging to a low salinity area. The urihaline forms belong to a moderately salinity area, and the true estuarine forms are seaward forms. More than 100 to 300 species of life thrive in an estuary. They may be classified into littoral forms, mid estuary forms and upper estuary forms. Because of high primary production and detritus food web, there are a lot of benthic inverts to consume. Birds and wildlife are more in estuarine environment. Estuaries are important feeding areas for many migrating birds. The estuarine shores show plovers, skimmers, gulls and oyster catchers. Birds consume the fishes, still others consume the vegetation. The reptiles of estuarine environment include sea turtles, which consume the fish, inverts and seagrasses. The mammals of estuaries include otters, nutria, dolphin and whales. Let us see the productivity of estuaries. The productivity of an estuary is high depending upon many factors. Mechanisms maintaining high productivity in estuaries are the primary producers, abundant nutrients, regeneration and conservation of nutrients, and the seasonal variations. Not all seasons are highly productive in estuaries, especially in temperate zones. In estuarine environments, organic substances are very important. The organic detritus controls the flow of feed in the estuarine environment. Nutrients in estuaries are higher than the oceans and the rivers. Because estuaries trap nutrients and the mixing resuspends them, primary producers are often not limited by nutrients as they are in the open ocean or in the rivers. This may be the most important factor controlling the production of estuaries. Let us see the production of estuaries. Estuaries are characterized by the high productivity. This results due to the constant supply of nutrients. The productivity may be 7 times more than an agricultural field and 20 times more than the open sea. The productivity of an estuary lies in the fisheries. Food and nutrition are brought by the tides and currents in the form of planktons and organic detritus. Estuaries are a good source of vitamin B12 for coastal waters. Estuaries are good places for settlement, sheltered boat landing, organized fisheries, holiday resorts, bird watching and recreational walking. The estuarine population faces certain peculiar and typical conditions as the penetration of marine species from seaside and littoral organisms at estuarine shores are more. The typical shape and character of coastal estuaries vary from place to place. It is also unstable due to many physical, geological, chemical and biological factors. The size and shape are influenced by the amount of fresh water entering the estuary and by the geological history of the area. The shallow waters, salt marshes, sea grasses and the mangrove roots provide excellent hiding places for larger open water predators. The saltwater grasses and other estuarine plants help prevent erosion and stabilize the shorelines, particularly in some estuaries. Estuaries support commercial and recreational fisheries, comprise important waterways for commercial shipping and recreational boating. They often serve as the direct recipient of processed industrial and municipal waste also. In addition, estuaries provide flood protection, draining of rainfall runoff from urban and agricultural land. In turn, the health of estuaries depends on the quantity, quality and timing of freshwater input into the estuaries. Many alterations happen due to man-made interference in coastal zones. These alterations have threatened and resulted in the loss of critical estuarine habitats and biological communities in many of the estuaries, and most of the estuarine systems are under risk due to human interference. Any alteration made in the ecosystem will destroy the life of the estuaries. Since estuaries are highly productive ecosystems, no man-made interference should affect or threat the life of the estuaries. It is necessary to protect the estuarine environment.